Introducing Uber Teens account, a linked Uber account for your teen with trackable trips and highly rated drivers. Receive 60% off your next three rides with Uber Teen accounts when using the promo code BCTeenFall23. Fans, Vodden Canada's goal is to give customers an authentic experience. Whether they're using one of our products in play or interacting with one of our team members, Vodden's mission statement to create products that athletes love represents what Vodden stands for and what is central to everything we do. Vodden Canada is once again proud to be the long-standing official sponsor for BC School Sports Football. Both teams are taking care of the coin toss at the moment. I will announce the officials for today's game. The head referee, the Sarge, Walter Becker. Umpire, Matt Pickering. Down judge, Dan Becker Jr. Line judge, Jason Edge. The back judge, Bill McKay. The observer, Brooke Hawkshaw. And the timer, Lester Caldwell. Vancouver College has won the toss, and they will receive to start this BC Grade 8 Football Championship. Let's go, fans! Duties today for the Panthers is number 6, Ty Schofield. Irish number 20, Alejandro Lando.
Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome inside BC Place Stadium, where the Grade 8 Championship game is getting underway here. The first of 5 straight contests here from under the dome, as it is nominally semifinal Saturday, but we do have a championship game getting us started. My name is Justin Morissette, pleased to be back here on the call for the high school championships in football, and joined as always by my commentary partner, my former grade 12 counselor as well, Jay Prepchuk. Jay, great to be doing this with you once again. And we got ourselves quite a tilt here to start it off. The Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers taking on the Vancouver College Fighting Irish in the Grade 8 championship game.
Absolutely, Justin. Great to be here with you again. Turnover on the very first play. Lord Tweedsmuir gets the opening kickoff. Boy, I tell you, they just recovered a little bit of a short kickoff there.
And a big run on the first play, but we got another turnover. It is a cold one, Jay, and perhaps the temperature is playing a factor here.
I think so, Justin. Boy, I tell you, two plays and two fumbles. As you said, I think these young guys are a little bit nervous this morning, and they're going to have to settle in. But Vancouver College, fortunate to get the football back for their first drive, starting on their own 25-yard line.
Fighting Irish able to recover the ball here, as you can see. Ball carrier for the Panthers, TJ Hooten. Lost his grip on it, and it is a chilly one here. If you're coming down for some of the games later on in the afternoon into the evening, make sure you dress warmly, as it is obviously an open-air arena, as it were. And the weather playing something of a factor. I got my fuzzy mittens on up here in the broadcast booth. Of course, they are not able to wear something like that down on the field, and I'm not sure it would help them hang on to the ball even if they could. But here we go. The Fighting Irish on their first drive of the game, having picked up the ball off of fumble. Second down. Irish elect to pass it, and it is complete out to the left side. Gain of about 7 on that play. Lucas Stevenson, the intended target, and he is able to haul that one in. For a good gain, third down, about 2.5 yards to go to a fresh set.
Yeah, nice job by quarterback Noah Gonzalez. Just a quick drop, hitting a curl route to his inside receiver and picking up a nice gain on second down.
See what Noah elects to do on down number 3. Takes the snap, is able to gather it in, and they'll hand the ball off for a run. This time in the hands of Rogan Bromley. Bromley busting loose. He is off to the races. My goodness, look at that young man rumble all the way to the end zone.
Wow, how about that? That's 50, 60, 70 yard touchdown rumble by the big man, Rogan Bromley. And we're going to hear the Bromley name quite a bit today, as, of course, his older brother plays for the varsity team for the varsity. Just over left tackle, nice job by the left-hand side of the offensive line, opening up just a huge hole. And Rogan Bromley doing the rest all the way down the left sideline for a big touchdown. Vancouver College goes up, scores the first touchdown of the Grade 8 championship.
On their first drive as well, their first set of downs, in fact. They hadn't even moved the sticks yet. And Rogan Bromley, I should say, goes the distance on that one. Opens the scoring with 8:25 remaining here in quarter number 1. Hot start for the Fighting Irish. Lots of time to play in this one, however, if you're the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
Yeah, absolutely. And Vancouver College, nice to see you electing to kick the extra point here.
Not something you see very often in the Grade 8 game.
Oh, exactly. And we got a little bit of a fake right away. And look at that.
They do indeed opt for a little trickery. Looked like they were going to punt it. Instead, they go for the 2-point convert. And the pass is complete to Davis Mann in the end zone. He's able to haul this one in as we take another look at it on the replay.
Wow, and a great job by the other quarterback. I'm not going to say backup because I know they split duties. But Ashton Power, who I've had the chance to coach actually both of these quarterbacks, and he's the holder. So always, as you know, quarterback being a holder, you always got to watch and make sure that you are watching for a fake. And that's exactly what Vancouver College did on that play, is they faked the extra point. And Ashton Power, even though he had Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers in his face, he was able to get that ball out for the 2-point convert. So again, Vancouver College goes up 8-0 to start this football game.
Quite the start and a little trick play. It seems a bit early to be reaching into the bag of tricks, perhaps. But Matt Esau having no trouble keeping that one up his sleeve, and it worked for him as well. Two-point convert, eight-point lead.
Yeah, I guess, again, a lot of film study, grade eight football, but these coaches, they're pretty intense. When I talked to Matt Esau, you know, during the week, he was like, you know, Lord Tweedsmuir, we got to be ready for their run. They run the ball 66% of the time. Coach, where you got the computer out, you've got this calculation. Boy, you're pretty serious about this championship game, as all the players and coaches, of course, are.
And if he's busting out trick plays less than 2 minutes into the contest, I can imagine he probably has a few more tricks hidden up his sleeve the rest of the way here. In the meantime, however, it's the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers who retake possession. Nikita Somek on the carry, on kick return, able to get that ball just past the 30, and I believe it's the 32-yard line where the Panthers will begin this drive. 33,
yeah,
in fact.
Yeah, nice job by Nikita just picking up that football. And, you kind of have one chance to pick up a live ball like that, and otherwise you have to dive on it. But Nikita does a nice job of getting the ball and getting upfield for a nice return.
As the Panthers now look to respond, perhaps with a score of their own, here early in the opening quarter of the Grade 8 Championship game under the dome at BC Place Stadium. As Lord Tweedsmuir elects to run the ball on first down, they put it in the hands of number 85, that's Devlin Hudem. And he'll pick up about three, and they'll bring up second and seven.
Yeah, nice job by, again, Tweedsmuir Panthers. Look like they enjoy running over the left-hand side of their offensive line. Two plays in a row, and both of them zone plays to the left-hand side over the left tackle and the left guard.
They go right back to the run once again, and again it's in the hands of Devlin Hudem as he will chew up short yardage yet again. Pick up another three and bring up third and four.
Yeah, and exactly. That's Frank Policilli, the head football coach. 30 years coaching experience. When I looked at the roster, I said, Frank is coaching this team, this grade eight team. And known Frank for a lot of years, and had a good chat with Frank during the week. And again, he's just wanting to make sure that they are able to maintain ball control and limit the turnovers today on this championship Saturday.
As you can hear the noisemakers from the Vancouver College faithful trying to make things difficult as this Panthers offense tries to go to work. And we have a injured player on the play, it looks like. As on third down, the Panthers come up about a yard and a half shy of a fresh set. We'll see what they elect to do here on fourth down. Bit of a gamble to go for it, of course, this early in the game with the field position they have. I would imagine they're about to punt this one away, but we will wait and see.
Absolutely. Big decision by Coach Frank here early in this football game. What's he going to do here? Like you said, Justin, it looks like it's just over a yard to go here. Pretty fancy yard marker down there, Justin. Do you notice that they've got the lit up ones this year that you can certainly see with my bad eyesight? I can tell what down it is. It's fourth down, of course, right? But pretty fancy in BC Place today. And boy, I tell you, there's coaches, Coach Yankana, all these coaches. It's great to see. I looked at the coaching list, and many BC High School ex-players have played. Joe Yankana, Joe Carter, so many of these guys that I had the opportunity to coach and that had fine coaching careers. And of course, their sons are playing today for both teams, Vancouver College and with Lord Tweedsmuir. So great to see those guys out coaching.
It's Devlin Hudem who has helped off the field, and he had been the focal point of this offense prior to that injury, so we'll see how the Panthers are able to survive his absence. But in the meantime, they did go for it on fourth down, and they did get the requisite yardage to move the sticks.
Yeah, nice job there by kind of almost a little Philadelphia Eagles pushers from behind there, but the quarterback, Jordan Thiessen, experienced quarterback, played a lot of football growing up in the Cloverdale minor program, but Jordan Thiessen with the big first down for the Panthers.
Panthers now try to go right back to the run as the Fighting Irish try to strip that ball loose once again, are unable to do so as it's TJ Houdon holding on to that one.
Yeah, I'm really impressed by the Lord Tweedsmuir Panther running backs. They're really fighting hard for extra yardage. And again, number seven, TJ does a great job of just picking up 3 yards on first down, even though the Vancouver College defense had him stopped right at the line of scrimmage. So great second effort by these Lord Tweedsmuir Panther running backs this morning.
And you can see the intention as well of the Fighting Irish. They were almost looking more for the strip than the tackle in the early stages of that play. As we've seen some turnovers here already early in this game, as now the Panthers going right back to the run. And it's Ethan Gray who is wrapped up and hauled down after he picks up about two on that play. That'll bring up third and five.
Yeah, there's your little jet sweep coming across the formation. Number 33 fighting hard to get upfield again. Just gets away from the first tackler, but Vancouver College swarming defense does a nice job of limiting the gain and bringing up a third and six situation for the Panthers.
Mason Palmer, the player to put a stop to that one for the defense on the Vancouver College side. Third down here, the Panthers still trying to march downfield, and they'll do so by going to the aerial game this time. A pass from Jordan Thiessen connecting with Ethan Gray. And that'll pick up, I believe, 8 yards at least. More than enough to move the chains. We got another Lord Tweedsmuir first down.
Yeah, I like the call. Jordan Thiessen again showing his outstanding passing ability, just getting the ball quickly and getting it out of his hands quickly, as he knows that Vancouver College is always going to be blitzing. They're always going to be bringing linebacker. Big first down for the Panthers.
Thiessen hands the ball off again, as the Panthers really favoring the run on this drive, and it's starting to work for them here. I believe they're going to pick up another first down. If not, it'll be just shy of the marker. TJ Houdon again, and that will move the sticks, in fact. Carry of 10 on first down will bring up another first down.
Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, great job by the running backs just to, kind of get away from that very first tackle from Vancouver College. They often have the running backs all set up and lined up to tackle them, and the running backs are doing a great job of breaking those initial tackles and picking up big gains.
As they go right back to the run once more. Once again, TJ Houdon, but he this time will be stopped up after a gain of 2 yards on the run. He's trying to go to the right side this time around. Didn't find the space, second and eight.
Yeah, exactly. And like Coach Frank told me all week, that they just have to try to neutralize that very physical, aggressive Vancouver College defense, who was in their 40 look, the 4-4 linebacker look, and it's again looking like they're blitzing linebackers every play.
And they're going to the sky. Jordan Thiessen gets that ball away, and it is hauled in as well. Javier Sidhu able to gather that one in, and they will move the sticks once more. Another first down as this Panthers offense continues to chip away. No huge plays on this drive necessarily, Jay, but they are getting it done. Play in and play out.
No, but how about that, Justin? As a grade A quarterback, just taking a three-step drop and hitting a breakout to his receiver, doing an excellent job. Again, Jordan Thiessen, 2 for 2 in the passing game. Great job so far, Jordan.
First and 10 yet again, as once more the Panthers go back to the running game, put the ball in the hands of TJ Houdon, but I believe he gets wrapped up for a loss behind the line of scrimmage. Indeed, he does. I'm going to say that was a loss of 2 yards on the carry and bring up second and 12.
Yeah, and you always know that when a team is starting to drive the football like Lord Tweedsmuir is doing, then Vancouver College, most defense, are going to start to bring a little bit more pressure, and that's exactly what Vancouver College did, blitzing linebackers on that and, really obviously limiting the game.
Thiessen gathers in the snap, gets that ball away, pass in the backfield, hoping that Jaden Lord could cut up after the reception. He does, and picks up about 5 after the fact. That'll bring up third and 7.
Yeah, I was just waiting for Jaden Lord to get the football, a young man that's been to many of my camps. And, you know, once Jaden Lord gets the ball in his hands, he's a very dangerous runner. Trips formation, just get that ball out to Jaden and get him doing the rest.
Takes the snap, looking skyward once again. Downfield, that pass hit off the hands of its intended receiver. I believe that was number 9, Connor Crowley, but he could not haul it in, and it will hit the turf incomplete. Bring up fourth down on what has been a pretty solid drive here for the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
Absolutely, and the thing I like about this drive as well, Justin, and today is, you know, Jordan is not just loading in or looking at one receiver. He's being able to spread the ball around a little bit, but a big fourth down gamble here early in this ball game.
Panthers gonna go for it on fourth down. They're inside the red zone as Thiessen puts the ball up, and he's picked off at the 6. The Fighting Irish able to intercept it. That's Alejandro Lando, I believe, number 20, who is able to gather this ball in.
Yeah, nice job by Alejandro there. And again, Alejandro, there's his dad on the sidelines cheering him on. Of course, the dad was a member of the Vancouver College Fighting Irish in the earlier days with Paul Del Monte coaching him, and had success at that time. And nice to see him out here coaching his boy. But big turnover. Again, fourth down gamble by the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers, and Thiessen just trying to get the ball into the end zone there unsuccessfully.
That's almost a costly interception for the defense, Jay, because he just gave up 12 yards by gathering that ball in instead of just knocking it to the turf for a turnover on downs. But we'll see what the Fighting Irish are able to do as they begin this drive by putting the ball in the hands of Mason Palmer. And he will cut up the middle for a gain of 10. Another first down for the Fighting Irish.
You're right, Justin. You've probably been wise, but if you saw yesterday, Javon Holland could have knocked down an interception from the Miami Dolphins, of course, and ran 99 yards for a touchdown on a pick six yesterday.
As the Irish go back to the run once again, this time the Panthers able to wrap it up at the line. Mason Palmer the carrier on that play yet again.
Yeah, another son of Kensley Palmer out there coaching, and a longtime football guy in BC coaching his son up here. It's great to see, again, all these alumni coming back and doing a great job of coaching.
I thought that was a no-gain play, but no, he picked up 2.5 yards. Do that 3 more times to get a fresh set of downs.
That's quarter time, Justin.
As the first quarter comes to an end, a quarter that has flown by here, largely due to the fact that both of these teams favored the running game by and large throughout quarter number one. That, of course, keeps the clock running. But we only have one score to report through the first 10 minutes of this one. It belongs to the Vancouver College Fighting Irish. A huge rushing touchdown from Rogan Bromley, who ate up more than half the field on the opening drive for Vancouver College.
Absolutely, and I had the opportunity to coach Rogan at many of my camps. He's also a quarterback, so maybe they've got the toss play in there as well somewhere. But Rogan Bromley, again, yes. You know, if you followed grade 8 football at all this year, which I know many of you have, of course, you saw that Rogan Bromley had many outstanding runs. If you look back at some of the highlights from Vancouver College this year, you will see one of the most outstanding runs that you will ever see, a kind of a Jerome Bettis type bus run, that breaking tackles and rumbling down the sideline. And again, it's not surprising to see that from Rogan Bromley, again, an outstanding young running back with Vancouver College. And as we mentioned earlier, his brother, of course, Hudson Bromley, is going to be featured back with Vancouver College playing in the game, the second to last game, the 4 o'clock game against Rutland, of course. And if you get a chance to come down, as Justin mentioned earlier, it is very chilly in BC Place. We've got the heaters going, we've got the gloves out, we've got the toques on, and we're keeping warm. It's going to be a long day for me anyways, Justin. I got all 5 games. You've got, people are going to be tired of hearing my voice, but Justin, I think we've got 3 together. And
we do indeed, and then it's Jake Elliott coming in to take over later on in the evening here on Semifinal Saturday, which begins with the Grade 8 Championship game the game we are being treated to as we speak, as Mason Palmer goes on yet another carry. And he chews up some yards this time with a sweep to the right side. That'll move the sticks for another Fighting Irish first down.
And you got to remember that, again, grade 8 football, it's only 10-minute quarter. So, yes, does it fly by? It really flies by fast, of course, right? It's a quick game, and again, with the clock running, of course, with an inbound tackle, then and setting the yardsticks, first down for Vancouver College.
First and 10 from the Vancouver College 29 as they go right back to the running game and put it in the hands of Rogan Bromley yet again. And why not with the success that he has already enjoyed so far this morning? Another big run for him. He'll pick up 8 yards on first down and bring up second and 2.
Yeah, and that's exactly, you know, Matt Esau, when I talked to him earlier in the week, the Vancouver College head coach, he was talking about making sure we control the line of scrimmage. He knows that Lord Tweedsmuir has a very, very aggressive defensive front line, and one of the keys to this football game is Vancouver College's offensive line controlling the line of scrimmage.
As Vancouver College will take a second to talk things over, though, I believe it's the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers who have called timeout on this one. Refocusing that defense.
Yeah, just get a chance. And as we said earlier, Justin, we've got a full slate of football games today. Of course, I saw the Chaco Valley Vikings led by the Brown brothers coming down and from all the way from Vanderhoof. They had a night in Vancouver last night, and they play at 11 o'clock, of course, against the Vernon Panthers, who also, of course, traveled down from Vernon. 1:30, we've got Barsby and Windsor, another rematch of those two football teams. 4 o'clock, Vancouver College and Rutland. 7 o'clock, Carson Graham, G.W. Graham. Stay tuned. What a day.
Battle of the Grahams in our main event this evening.
Yeah, I got you there.
In the meantime, the Panthers looking to make a stop here. Not able to do so as the Fighting Irish put the ball right back in the hands of Rogan Bromley yet again. This time he'll pick up about 4, but that was about double what he needed to move the chains. First down, Vancouver College.
Yeah, just a quick search dive play over the right guard. Vancouver College doing a nice job of opening up those holes against a very, very talented Lord Tweedsmuir Panther defense.
Long snap, ball's handed off for a rush yet again, this time in the hands of who else but Rogan Bromley. And this time, the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers have the answer. They're able to stop him behind the line, a loss of a yard, second and 11.
Yeah, and of course, that has got to be the key in early penetration. Nice job by Nikita to get in there and, again, only really a loss of 1 yard there, bringing up a second and long situation. Nice job by Nikita to penetrate and limit Bromley on that gain.
Nikita Somick, one of 3 defensive players, making something of a gang tackle on Rogan Bromley on that last play. This time, however, the Fighting Irish go right back to the run and enjoy great success there yet again. A 15-yard pickup on a left-side sweep. That ball in the hands of Alejandro Lando.
Nice job, a great play call, just faking up the middle. They've had success getting the ball up the middle, and excellent job by quarterback Noah Gonzalez with a fake to Bromley up the middle, sucked those linebackers up and hitting Alejandro in the left-hand flat and doing a nice job of picking up a big first down for Vancouver College. And, you know, they're up 8-0 right now. This is a pivotal time of this football game, Justin.
It is indeed. Connor Crowley, the defensive player who was able to force Lando outside the lines and put a halt to that play at the 44 inside Panthers territory.
A little trickery.
Ooh. Reversal on that one as that ball winds up in the hands of Mason Palmer, and he will pick up about 12 at least, more than enough to move the sticks. We have yet another Fighting Irish first down.
Okay, we got a little trickery, first trickery of the day there. Good job by Noah Gonzalez getting the ball out to the flat, and Palmer with a little flea flicker, little hook and ladder, I should say, picking up another first down for Vancouver College. So a little bit of trickery from Vancouver College on their convert and also on that play in the second quarter drive.
Yeah, I was going to say that's their second trick play of the day if you include their two-point convert. That's the play that has them in an 8-0 lead, nearly 3 minutes gone here in the second quarter of the Grade 8 championship game between Vancouver College and Lord Tweedsmuir. As this time, Mason Palmer is brought down for a loss. And the Lord Tweedsmuir defense doing a good job of figuring out the Vancouver College running game as this game continues.
Yeah, Vancouver College is trying to pull their backside guard and kick out. Unfortunately, that guard just didn't get across. And again, outstanding penetration by Nikita, number 77, and also TJ Hutton, number 7. Outstanding defense by the Panthers.
As that pass is complete and makes its way into the hands of Alejandro Lando, yet again, Noah Gonzalez put some zing on that one.
Yeah, he did, Justin, absolutely. And just a doubles formation, 2x2 formation, and against a cover three, it's a little bit of a weakness in that defense. That middle safety's there, and he's got two seam routes coming at him, and nice job by Noe putting the ball right on the money to Alejandro Lando.
And he made that decision about as quickly as could be. See what he elects to do here. Low snap, they'll hand the ball off for a rush, and I believe that will be just shy of the requisite yards to move the sticks on first down. Or for a first down, I should say. That rush in the hands of Rogan Bromley, I believe, going to be just shy, and that'll bring up fourth down, fourth and 1.5 to go.
Yeah, nice job by Connor Crowley there to limit that gain there. And, again, you know, Rogan, just a big, powerful running back to limit him up for a gain of 1 yard. Just outstanding defense.
Fighting Irish going to go for it here on fourth down. You knew that they would, as they'll go right back to the rush and put the ball in the hands of Alejandro Lando, but we do have a penalty flag on the field.
Yeah, it's going to be procedure against Vancouver College. We tailback just jumped a little. There's Walter Becker, the Sarge. There's the veteran. Longtime coach at North Delta Secondary, the Huskies of North Delta, BC Championship in the mid-90s with Walter Becker as the head coach, coached many, many fine football players in his day. And you know what? Nothing's going to get past Walter Becker. And procedure call on that and bringing up a fourth and sixth situation for Vancouver College, staying in an I-back formation.
As the Fighting Irish go for it on fourth down, and they will move the sticks. This drive continues. Oscar Chung with a huge grab.
Big call on fourth down. Flood pass, just an eye back flood pass. And Noah Gonzalez doing a great job of showing patience, rolling to his right-hand side. Didn't like what he saw on the flat. Great coverage by the Panthers. He came all the way back to his backside receiver, Oscar Chang, for a big, big first down for Vancouver College.
We got another penalty flag on the field here. This one ahead of the snap.
Again, we're going to have another procedure call, and both coaches talked about that during the week, is just mistakes are going to kill you when you are, of course, playing in a championship football game.
As they put the ball right back in the hands of Rogan Bromley, and he will muscle his way to the end zone once again. Two scores in this game. They both belong to the same player, and that is that young man right there, Rogan Bromley, his second touchdown of the day to put Vancouver College up 14-0 with 4:21 to go in the first half.
There you go, in an 82-yard drive. How about that? An 82-yard drive by a Grade 8 football team. Vancouver College doing a nice job of mixing up the pass and run and scoring their second touchdown of the game. Again, Rogan Bromley with a nice job over the right guard.
As the Fighting Irish go for the two-point convert yet again here. And no trick play this time. They're not faking the punt. Pass to the end zone, and it is hauled in. It is good. Alejandro Lando able to gather that ball in. Was waiting to see if they were going to say he was downed as he took it. But I believe that is a good two-point convert. And the Fighting Irish take a 16-0 lead.
Yeah, nice job by Noah Gonzalez. We've got another penalty here. DeSarge got a holding call against Vancouver College. It's going to back him up. But that was a nice job by Noah Gonzalez. Looking like it's easy to tell who his favorite receiver is, certainly, in this football game, is Alejandro Lando, who also, of course, had a pick early in the interception earlier in this football game.
So I'm a little bit confused at the moment, Jay. Did that two-point convert get negated by the penalty flag?
It did. We've got 16 on the board, but we'll be taking that down.
So as they go for it again, this time that pass goes incomplete, and it is, in fact, a 14-0 score here that favors Vancouver College.
Yeah, 4 minutes now and 21 seconds left, of course, in the second quarter here. Let's see if Lord Tweedsmuir now, they've got just enough time to get that football down the field and see if they can put up a score, because Vancouver College did initially receive or elect to receive the opening kickoff. So I would assume that the Panthers are going to be getting the ball to start the second quarter. So let's see if they can put a little Kansas City Chiefs drive. We all know that the Kansas City Chiefs are so effective late in the second quarter. And again, let's see if Coach Policelli's group, the Panthers, can get down the field and get on the scoreboard, Justin.
They did a great job on their previous drive of really marching it downfield. Got inside the red zone. I believe that drive was stopped at about the 18-yard line. See if they can do it again. Of course, when you run the ball as often as these teams do and it's 10-minute quarters, one big drive can eat up a lot of time off that clock, and that has certainly been the case here in quarter number two as Tweedsmuir gets the ball back in the hands of Nikita Somek, and he's going to take that all the way inside Fighting Irish territory, brought down at the 46. That is one heck of a kick return and gives this team prime field position to try and author a scoring drive.
Absolutely, and isn't it great to see Nikita is showing his talents today, not only on the defensive line making many big plays for that Panther defense, but also outstanding kick return, giving the Panthers exactly what they needed, Justin. Great field position with 4 minutes and 15 seconds left in the second quarter. Let's see if the Panthers can take advantage of that great return.
Jordan Thiessen takes the snap, hands the ball off. They try for a run up the middle, this time in the hands of TJ Hutton, and he is wrapped up and brought down as he hits the line of scrimmage. Maybe a short gain of one that'll bring up second and nine.
Nice job by the Vancouver College defense, as we mentioned earlier. They usually like to blitz. They blitz at least one linebacker. They've got that 40 look up front, four defensive linemen, four linebackers, and three defensive backs. Let's see if Vancouver College continues to blitz a linebacker.
Thiessen takes the snap. This time he looks to the sky. The pass is away. It is caught along the left side. Jovier Sidhu able to gather that one in, and he will pick up a short gain as well, maybe 4 yards this time. Third down, about six to go to a fresh set.
Yeah, I like the call, faking the jet sweep to the right-hand side and coming back to the left-hand side and hitting Sidhu just on a little hitch pattern, and Sidhu doing a nice job of getting the ball up the field again. The clock is going to be a factor here. The Panthers have got to try to speed up their offense a bit here.
It is ticking as we speak. 3 minutes remaining here in quarter number two as the Panthers go right back to the run game, putting the ball in the hands of TJ Hutton once more. And a good little pickup, but not quite enough to move the sticks. It'll bring up fourth down, and I believe they are 1 yard shy of a new set of downs.
Yeah, very impressed by TJ Hutton and the rest and the other running backs from the Panthers. This is their second effort. Vancouver College often has them wrapped up at the line of scrimmage, but great second effort by the Panther running backs to gain extra yards.
And no surprise here, Lord Tweedsmuir going for it on fourth down.
I don't think so, Justin. I don't think so.
That was a little chaotic, Jan. I'm not even sure I know what happened there. Yeah, so take another look at it.
Just trying to get a quarterback sneak in there, but great penetration by Vancouver College. Number 60, Zach Langley, did a great job of penetrating that B gap and limiting that gain, of course, and just Jordan Thiessen, the quarterback, on the last quarterback sneak, of course, on fourth down, picked up the first down, but not that play. Great job by number 60, Jack Langley of the Vancouver College Fighting Irish, to stop that Panther drive.
Chaotic play that was over really before it got started, and it leads to a turnover on downs as the Fighting Irish will take the field once again with 2:18 to go here in the second quarter. Looking to stretch their lead before the half. Can they do it? They put the ball back in the hands of Rogan Bromley. He's got both of the touchdowns in this game, and he'll pick up some short yardage to begin this drive. Gain of 3 at the most, and I believe that'll bring up 2nd and 7.
Yeah, always interesting, Justin, to see what the coaches want to do in this situation. With just over 2 minutes left, Vancouver College 60 yards away from the Panther goal line. Are they going to play with a lightning, kind of a hurry-up offense, or are they just going to be settled with giving the ball to Bromley and kind of grinding this half out and going into the locker room with a 14-0 lead?
As they go right back to Bromley, this time he finds a hole in a big way, but is wrapped up by the ankles and hauled down after a pickup of nearly 15. This guy is something else, I tell you.
Yeah, he really is. And just showing his patience again, great feed, very much like, as we talked about, Jerome Bettis. He kind of very patient, the line of scrimmage. The initial hole wasn't there, but nice job by Bromley to kind of do a little jump cut and get to the outside and pick up a big first down for Vancouver College.
Fighting Irish now on the 45 inside enemy territory as this drive continues. Looking skyward, a pass that was intended for Alejandro Lando. Falls harmlessly incomplete, though there were a number of Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers in that area defensively who would have liked to scoop it up, I'm sure.
Yeah, again, Noah Gonzalez coming back to the inside seam route, trying to hit Alejandro Lando on that inside seam route that he was very successful with on the last drive from Vancouver College.
2nd and 10 now from the 45. 71 seconds remaining in the half. As Noah Gonzalez, scrambling somewhat, elected to run the ball himself, but didn't have anywhere to take it, as he's wrapped up and brought down for a loss of 3 yards, 3rd and 13.
Yeah, a little play action pass, and Noah trying to get the ball out to the left hand flat to Alejandro, but the Panthers did a nice job of corralling him and bringing down a good tackle by Ethan Gray, the fine linebacker from the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers. So, again, decision time here for Vancouver College. I think it's a smart idea to call their second timeout of the half and just kind of settle things down a little bit, and let's see what we have in our playbook to come up with a 3rd and 12 play with only a minute left in the second quarter.
See if they put the ball back in the hands of Rogan Bromley, because he seems like he can pick up 12 yards at will at times so far in the early stages of this game. 1 minute left in the half. Fighting Irish already with a 14-0 lead over Lord Tweedsmuir. Vancouver College with a receiver in motion. Gonzalez will hand the ball off to Rogan Bromley, just as I suspected. He'll pick up 3, not very much.
Yeah, good call, Justin. You're absolutely correct. Vancouver College just trying to kind of spread out that Panther defense, running doubles formation and having the receiver go across the formation, try to look like they're going to pass the football, and a nice job by the Tweedsmuir Panthers. They kind of figured out, it looks like, that they're, you know, we got to tackle this guy low. I'm sure the coaches stressed that all week, but a nice tackle in there by number 85, Devlin Hudeman, that, limited that gain. And again, Vancouver College here with a fourth down situation. Looks like they're going to, they certainly have a chance to run the clock, but it looks like there's a timeout
on
the field.
Yeah, there was indeed. Yeah. As I believe that the Fighting Irish may have elected to go back to the run with Rogan Bromley, in part to keep the clock running here as well, but it's the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers who call timeout.
Yeah, smart
as
play.
A turnover on downs here on fourth down would give them the ball at their own 45 with 42 seconds still left here in the half.
Smart play by the Panther defense.
No Gonzalez looking skyward. The pass is away, complete to Rogan Bromley, and Bromley, I believe, will get just enough to move the sticks, but we'll see where this ball is spotted. It's going to be awfully close. I wouldn't be surprised if they have to bring the chains out for a measurement on this one, Jay.
Yeah, this is going to be really close. Of course, his knee was touching down, and Bromley did a nice job of extending the ball, but was his knee down before the extension of the ball took place? So
they're going to say yes. This is a turnover on downs. Lord Tweedsmuir taking possession now at their own 36. First and 10 with 36 seconds on the clock as well.
Watch out for Jaden Lord getting the ball here. There he goes.
Hand off to Jaden Lord off the snap. We do have a flag on the field as Lord is wrapped up and hauled down as he gets back to the line of scrimmage, but we'll see who this penalty flag is assessed against.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to get a holding call on the edge. And, of course, that's what happens. And the veteran Walter Becker referee knows that on those fly sweeps, he's always going to be looking at the edge, always going to be looking at the edge blockers. And in that case, the Panthers looked like they got a little bit of cloth from the Vancouver College defense. And unfortunately, it's going to negate that gain by the outstanding receiver from the Panthers, Jaden Lord.
Walter Becker laying down the law yet again. As Sarge and his troops march that ball back 10 yards. Replay first down. Now 29 seconds remaining here in the half.
Again, call timeout. Just to, again, let's get organized here. Let's just make sure that, again, both sides are, you know, coaches in and just coaching, even though, again, championship game. They've been going at this since August. They've put in their prevent defense. They put in their short yardage. They put in their long yardage situations. And but still, the coaches just coaching. Just a great job by both of these football programs. The coaches, lots of coaches on both of these football teams giving back to the great game of football.
And, of course, while this game feels like the end of the journey this season for a number of these players, it's really just the beginning. We're going to be hearing these names for years and years to come here in the BC High School football program, as Lord Tweedsmuir will complete the pass to the near side this time. Ball hits the hands of number 19, Jaden Lord, and he will pick up about five, but has a long way to go. Second and 15.
Yeah, I like the call, and again, I love the technique here by Jordan Thiessen, a young man that I had a chance to work with when he was a lot younger, and it's nice to see his fundamentals are so sound right now, and just getting the football, one-step drop, getting the ball out, getting into his playmaker's hands. Jaden Lord picking up a nice gain, but again, with only 22 seconds left, let's see if they can get the ball down the field.
Thiessen now going deep. Pass complete to Jaden Lord. Wow! What an arm on Jordan Thiessen to make that happen, and what a grab from Jaden Lord to haul it in. Pass complete.
I like the call. You're going to see by the replay, Jaden Lord from an inside position just running a wheel route, out and up route, and again, just putting the ball perfectly right near the sidelines. Jaden Lord getting out of bounds and stopping the clock here. 16 seconds left. Let's see if the Panthers can maintain this drive.
16 seconds to go. First down from the 45. Panthers going to look deep once again as Jordan Thiessen peels out of the pocket, but he's brought down before he can get that ball away. And the clock is still running. Panthers trying to get back in position for one more play. I believe time's going to run out on them.
They're not going to get it.
But
the Panthers running the exact same play, Justin. They ran the wheel route, but Vancouver College is not going to be fooled twice in a row, and they had great defensive coverage by the Vancouver College Fighting Irish defense, and Thiessen did a nice job of not throwing the ball up there. And again, the Vancouver College defense coming up with a solid first half.
It might not have been the end of the half that the Panthers were hoping for, as they do go back to the room scoreless, unfortunately. But a lot of good stuff, I think, on that last drive. Momentum that they will look to carry with them into quarter number three as they hope to get on the board, trailing the Vancouver College Fighting Irish 14-0 after the opening half. We'll take a quick 15-minute intermission here, folks. But come on back. Before we go, do want to let you know that among our many proud sponsors making the BCSS Fall Championship Games happen this year, BC Dairy is proud to support BC School Sports. On behalf of BC Dairy Farmers, we are dedicated to supporting student athletes across the province and building lasting relationships within our communities. Learn more at bcdairy.ca. So go pour yourself a tall glass of milk. We'll be back with more action. It's the first of five straight games here at BC Play Stadium. Semifinal Saturday, Justin Morissette and Jay Prepchuk bringing you the action. We'll be back with more before you know it. Thank you.
Truth is bulletproof, there's no fooling you. I don't dress the same. Me and two, you say hours yesterday have gone our separate ways. Left my living fast somewhere in the past, cause that's a chasing car. Turns out open bars lead to broken hearts. I'm going way too far. Cause I used to be young. Take one, pour it out. It's not worth crying about the things you can't erase, like tattoos and regrets, words I never meant, the ones that got away. Left my living fast somewhere in the past and took another road. Turns out crowded rooms empty out as soon as be crazy, messed up, but God, was it fun? I know it used to be wild. That's good. To be young.
introducing Urban Teen Account, Uber Teen Accounts, a linked Uber account for your teen with trackable trips and highly rated drivers. Receive 60% off your next three rides with Uber Teen Accounts when using the promo code BCTeenFall23. Fans, Bodden's Canada's goal is to give customers an authentic experience. Whether they're using one of our products in play or interacting with one of our team members, Bodden's mission statement to create products that athletes love represents what Bodden stands for and what is central to everything we do. Bodden Canada is once again proud to be the long-standing official sponsor of BC Sports Football.
Intermission is in the books, and it is nearly time to get the second half started here in the Grade 8 Championship game. The Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers taking on the Vancouver College Fighting Irish, and it's been all Vancouver College so far in this one as far as scoring goes anyways. Fighting Irish up 14-0 here as we prepare to enter quarter number three. Justin Morissette and Jay Prepchuk bringing you the action from BC Place Stadium. The first of five games here on semifinal Saturday, though it is the only championship game of the day, of course. And Jay, a pretty strong opening, I think, from both teams. Lord Tweedsmuir yet to find the scoreboard, but they have a lot of positives to build on as they'll try and recover this ball off the kickoff. And they are able to do so. Ethan Gray able to gather that one in. That was a bit of a dangerous scenario there. A loose ball that could have been jumped on by the Fighting Irish. But it is indeed Lord Tweedsmuir's ball, and they will begin this drive from their own 34.
Right. And as you said, you know, Lord Tweedsmuir did a lot of great things in the first half. They had well over 100 yards in total offense. And let's see if they can just, you know, maintain getting the ball to number 19, Jaden Lord, and getting it into the playmaker's hands here. And, of course, they have a fine quarterback in Jordan Thiessen that can make things happen.
So we'll see if they're able to carry some of that positive momentum from the tail end of the second quarter into the beginning of quarter number three. But they are stopped up on the run on the first play of the half. T.J. Hutton just bowled over as he tried to run up the near side.
You know, very impressed here, Justin, with a lot of that, just the simple techniques of some of these football players. Again, the passing of Jordan Thiessen, the passing of Noah Gonzalez, but also some of the fundamentals. You could see the running back getting the handoff, two hands on the ball, just fundamentals that you can see that the coaches have done an outstanding job of coaching fundamental football. And that's one of the reasons they're in the championship game today.
As Jordan Thiessen's offense goes back to work here, he'll take the snap, think about passing, and he elect to run the ball himself. I believe that was a desperation call, however, as he felt that blitz closing in around him, and he is brought down for a loss on this one, unfortunately. Short loss, third and 12.
Yeah, a nice job by Vancouver College of not being fooled there. It looked like maybe a quarterback draw that they had set up for Jordan Thiessen to get up the middle and get some positive yards, but Vancouver College middle linebackers were not fooled with the cross formation from Jaden Lord.
Jaden Lord with a huge grab near the tail end of that opening half. Perhaps the biggest offensive play of the day so far for Lord Tweedsmuir, as the pass is complete in the flats out to Jovier Sadu, but he can't go very far with it before he's wrapped up and brought down after a gain of 2.5.
Yeah, I like the call. Motioning Jaden Lord across the formation, setting up a one-on-one situation with Sadu and Lando, but Lando does a nice job of coming up and securing the tackle. He's all by himself on that island, but a nice job, again, by the two-way outstanding player, Alejandro Lando from Vancouver College, number 20.
And it is so impressive when you look at the depth that the Fighting Irish have. Just a quick glance over to their sideline will show you how many players they have at their disposal. And yet it seems like the key guys, like Alejandro Lando, are playing nearly every minute of this contest, as Lord Tweedsmuir tried to go deep on fourth down, a desperation Hail Mary play, and the pass a little bit out of the reach of its intended receiver. Incomplete is the call, turnover on downs, and the Fighting Irish will retake possession in prime position here. They're going to begin this drive from the 35 inside Panthers territory.
Wow, big decision by the Panthers there to go for it on fourth down, and unsuccessful play. They ran that wheel route trying to hit Jaden Lord on the out and up route, but you know that Vancouver College at the halftime intermission, they talked about that play and they made sure that the corner stayed home. Vancouver College did a nice job of defending that play.
Noah Gonzalez now and his offense going back to work. They'll put the ball in the hands of Mason Palmer with their first play of the new half. And Palmer will pick up some good yards on that one. I believe he's forced out at the 30, so gain of 5, second and 5.
Vancouver College coming out in the second half, starting with an I-back formation with the fullback, number 4, Rogan Bromley, kicking out the defensive end, and a nice job by Mason Palmer. Sure, a luxury for Vancouver College to have these outstanding, many outstanding running backs in Palmer and Bromley.
And both of those guys towering over the competition as they have physically developed at a young age, let's say, as that pass was intended for Rogan Bromley, knocked out of the sky instead. I believe that was Devlin Hudum who was able to knock that one down.
Yeah, Hudum did a nice job, boy, Justin. If he had caught that football, he had nobody in front of him. He would have gone for a touchdown, and boy, Vancouver College very fortunate there that that ball was not intercepted. An inside seam route intended for Rogan Bromley.
Third and five now after that second down pass was incomplete. They'll hand the ball off again, this time to Mason Palmer once more, but he's brought down for a loss of about 3 yards, I believe. They're going to say four, in fact, and it'll bring up fourth and nine. Curious to see what the Fighting Irish will do here on fourth down.
Yeah, at the bottom of that pile, excellent job by number six, Ty Schofield, who knifed in from his linebacker position to do an excellent job of limiting that gain. And again, the blitzing linebacker did a nice job of anticipating that snap count and getting through and making the big tackle for the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
Noah Gonzalez takes the long snap, looking skyward, ball is away, incomplete, overthrown. I believe he was intending to find Tyson Gallagher, but instead, nobody there but Landon Spencer. Rather, that was Rashawn Power, number two, not number one. The defensive player making sure that ball fell harmlessly incomplete. Another turnover on downs here as it's the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers who retake possession.
Yeah, big break for the Panthers there. And let's see if they can generate some offense here again. You know, in grade eight football, there's only 10-minute quarters, so they really don't have a lot of time here. It's going to be interesting to see if the Panthers can maintain that drive and get down the field and score a touchdown.
If I'm not mistaken, Jay, I believe that's the Fighting Irish's first three and out of the day. So great job from the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers defense. We'll see what their offense can do here. And on their first play of the drive, they will move the sticks. That ball in the hands of T.J. Hutton does get 10 yards more, in fact. They're going to be first and 10 from their 45.
Yeah, love the call. Love the call getting the ball out on first down on a screen play. You've got Vancouver College, very, very physical, blitzing defense. Excellent call on first down to get the ball to T.J. Hutton, picking up a big first down.
So a big stop from the Panthers' defense, and now their offense off to a hot start on this drive as well. Long snap into the hands of Jordan Thiessen. He will hand that ball off. And another pickup of decent size, this time in the hands of Devlin Hutton. I believe he will pick up eight on that carry and bring up second and two.
Yeah, nice job by the Panthers just getting the ball into Hutton's hands and on a little nice job by bouncing the ball outside there. Number 52 from Vancouver College, Rain Mannick, did a nice job of penetrating and, having the running back bounce to the outside. But again, nice job by the Panther running back to bounce the ball to the outside and pick up a big gain on second down, on first down.
And credit to the ball carrier as well, just continued to move those feet, pumping away to pick up some extra yardage after he hit some contact. The drive continues here for the Panthers. They've already moved the ball 18 yards so far on this drive off really just two plays. This time, short pass connects with T.J. Hutton, and I believe that will be a loss of yards. Yes, he's lost two on that play, third and four.
Yeah, the Panthers coming back with the screen pass, this time to the right-hand side, but Vancouver College was not fooled on that particular play. Great job by number 50 to snuff out that screen pass and bring up a big third down and four situation. I assume the Panthers are going to be in four-down territory here, Justin.
I think they're in four-down territory all day long the rest of this game, no matter what happens, Jay, but they're going deep on third. That pass intended for Jovier Sidhu, and he pops up arguing for a pass interference call. We do have a flag on the field. I think he's going to get it.
Absolutely. It's going to be pass interference against Vancouver College. It's going to be a 15-yard penalty, and here's Sarge giving the instructions. Yeah, it's going to be pass interference on Vancouver College. Big break by the Panthers here. Get the ball down the field now for bringing up a big first down for the Panthers, just the break that the Panthers needed.
They have been making their own luck on this drive, though, certainly. hard work paying off for Lord Tweedsmuir.
Yeah, they've done a nice job, Justin, of, you know, mixing the pass and the run, and let's see if they continue to try to get the ball into their playmakers' hands, look for the ball to go to Jaden Lord, maybe on a fly sweep here, or just want to try to maintain this drive, keep the ball away from the Vancouver College, very potent offense, and see if they can just drive the ball down the field and, of course, get a very, very important score in this third quarter.
Fresh ball coming over from the sidelines. If I had to guess, probably care of the fine folks at Baden.
Absolutely.
One of our many sponsors here.
Baden has been a great sponsor for many, many years of BC High School football. Great people at Baden, great products, and thank you again, all the sponsors. Baden, again, thank you very much for your support.
Deason takes the snap. We'll hand that ball off immediately to TJ Hutton. Hutton trying to cut to the far side, and he will pick up about 5 yards before he's brought down, but a nice little carry. Bring up second and five.
Yeah, nice job by Hutton. Just a kind of a jet sweep, but cutting the ball inside. Nice job by Hutton to read that play. And usually it's a play that runs to the outside, but the defensive end of Vancouver College did a nice job, and Hutton did a nice job of turning that ball up the field and picking up 5 yards on first down.
Looked like he could have had more as well. I believe it was the turf that did him in ultimately on that one. Second down now as the Panthers continue to push the ball upfield. This time they go right back to the run. And it was Devlin Hudum this time. We'll move that ball forward another 2 or 3 yards or so.
Yeah, and Justin, you know, you mentioned earlier that these guys just grade eight football right now, but and they have a, you know, what a, two great football programs. Nick Kawaza, of course, the head football coach at Lord Tweedsmuir, and Brian Chu, the head football coach of the varsity teams at Vancouver College. So, you know, these young men have a lot of football left in them, that's for sure.
They are lucky to be hearing their names called under the dome here by our great PA announcer, of course, but I would hazard a guess, Jay, that for many of them that is not the first or only time that this will happen for them. They have many great years, of course, of football to look forward to here in BC high school ranks.
Yeah, absolutely. And a little option play by Lord Tweedsmuir there did not fool number 68, Lucas Fabro, as a defensive end, did a nice job of just basically dismantling that play. And again, another big fourth down gamble here from the Panthers, fourth and eight from the Vancouver College 33-yard line.
They have a flag on the field immediately, but the pass connects. Oh, my. All the way to the end zone. Ethan Gray, what a reception. What a touchdown. The question is, who is that penalty flag going to be assessed against? Does this touchdown, in fact, count?
Boy, this is going to be an interesting call here. The referees gathering here at right near the line of scrimmage. We're going to look like we're going to get a hold on Tweedsmuir, and probably maybe a procedure or offside call, illegal formation. Hold is the call.
And that is a tough break for the Panthers. Their first scoring play of the day immediately negated by penalty flags. And what a play that was for Ethan Gray. My goodness. He basically took that ball in right at the line of scrimmage.
Outstanding blocking. Number seven, Hutton, T.J. Hutton, had an outstanding block on the Vancouver College corner to kind of spring that spring Ethan Gray loose there. And boy, I tell you, that was just an unfortunate break there from the Panthers. Fourth and 15, look for them to come back and just get that ball up in the air to Jaden Lord, maybe a wheel route to the left-hand side.
Number 33 went 33 yards to the house. The question is, can he do it again? We got another penalty flag here, but the pass connects once more. Incredible stuff as Jordan Thiessen finds Jaden Lord downfield. Will this one count, however? More laundry on the field.
Yeah, a call like that, it looks like maybe they illegal formation. You have to have seven players on the line of scrimmage. And, oh, boy, I tell you, we knew that they were going to throw the ball up to Jaden Lord, but it looked like a procedure call or a legal formation. Yeah, we didn't have enough guys on the line of scrimmage. Panthers, oh, that's just unfortunate. Two touchdowns in a row coming back for the Panthers.
One touchdown and a first down. But,
and a first down, that's right.
Close.
Sorry, thanks, Justin. Yeah,
good,
exactly. But, boy, I tell
two
you
two huge plays, though, and now you're looking at a very, very long field in front of you. Now on the 46, they need to get the ball to the 24. They need 22 yards here on fourth down. And they've got it the last couple. Can they do it again and try to avoid taking a penalty this time?
Well, they certainly have the quarterback that has the arm strength to get the ball down the field. Oh, it looks like they're in punt formation.
Jordan Thiessen demonstrating that he's got quite the arm on him over the course of this drive. They will punt it, though, and that punt partially blocked before it rolls out of bounds. So an unfortunate end to what had been a largely successful drive for Lord Tweedsmuir, and the Panthers will have to wait even longer to get on the board after a touchdown walked back by a penalty flag. Ethan Gray's 33-yard reception, unfortunately, all for naught.
Exactly. Boy, I tell you, penalties, you know, obviously very costly in championship football games, and both coaches talked about that throughout the week, is that to make sure you limit the mistakes, and unfortunately for the Panthers, two big mistakes for them that brought back a touchdown and a big play, big catch by Jaden Lord. Watch for a heavy dose of Mr. Bromley here.
As they go right to him to begin the drive, Rogan Bromley looking like a man amongst boys in this game. He's got some good size to him, and it feels like, Jay, these grade eights are coming smaller and smaller every year.
It does. It does, exactly. But I tell you, you know what? These guys are some tough kids out there. And though they lack size, they don't lack heart. And it's very, very impressive. You know, we talked about these players both from both teams, you know, playing football and having great careers ahead of them. But I know that a lot of the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers, these boys grew up playing together. They kind of kudos to the Cloverdale minor football program who have fed, you know, into the high schools. And a lot of these boys have been playing together for many, many years with the Cloverdale minor football program.
As the Fighting Irish go right back to work here, that first yard run from Rogan Bromley walked back on a penalty flag. Repeat first down after taking it 5 yards back. And we have a fumble on the field that the Panthers believe they have come up with. Connor Crowley first on that loose ball. And there you go. Some hard work and determination from Lord Tweedsmuir puts them right back to work on offense.
Just a great job by the defensive end, Ethan Gray. Boy, Ethan Gray's having a heck of a football game today, Justin. From his defensive end position, was refused to get reach blocked by the tight end of Vancouver College. Did a nice job of coming up and causing that fumble. Big break for the Panthers, but again, Ethan did a nice job of getting upfield and creating that turnover.
Talking about the size of these kids, Jordan Thiessen, maybe one of the smallest players on the field, but what an arm on him. He did not display it on first down of this drive, instead handing the ball off to Ethan Gray, and Gray cuts up with a far side sweep. Gain of 4 yards on the carry, second and six, and once again, for the second time today, the Panthers are in the red zone, ball currently on the 19-yard line.
Yeah, nice job by Ethan Gray picking up a big, big gain on first down of 5 yards. Second and five for the Panthers. Let's see if they can punch this ball in, Justin.
Thiessen puts it skyward and very nearly connects with Ethan Gray in the end zone. Instead, that one sails maybe a yard out of his grasp, just a little too high, but nearly there.
Oh, boy.
So close.
Yeah, so close. Again, the Panthers running their favorite pass play, trips formation, taking the wide receiver, running him on a post route, running that inside receiver. Usually they've run that play with Jaden Lord, but on that particular play, trying to get the ball to their outstanding receiver, Ethan Gray, and just a little bit overthrown from the quarterback, Jordan Thiessen.
16 seconds to go here in quarter number three as Thiessen, his pass, connects. with Jaden Lord. It was a short pass, however, and Lord brought down immediately. So a loss of yardage on this one. A significant loss, in fact. They go from 3rd and 6 to 4th and 15.
Wow, how about that catch? Unfortunately, it wasn't a big gain for Jaden Lord, but just kind of a little OBJ one-handed catch there. And nice job by the Vancouver College defense. Mason Palmer, who, of course, is also the fine tailback for the Vancouver College Fighting Irish, he wasn't fooled by that play and did a great job of coming up and making the tackle and, again, putting the Panthers in a fourth down and long situation.
We will have to wait, however, for that fourth down as the buzzer sounds to signal the end of the third quarter. These teams will march down to the other end of the field for the final quarter of regulation. And with 10 minutes left to play, the Vancouver College Fighting Irish with a 14-0 lead over the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers. But as we've said many times already, Jay, I don't think that scoreboard tells the story of this game. The Panthers have certainly been better than a team that has 0 points on the board.
Absolutely. They have really played. I give credit to, you know, both coaching staffs, of course. They are so well prepared for this football game. When I talk to both head coaches, Coach Frank and Coach Matt Esau, throughout the week, they had both, you know, gave me full explanations and full scouting reports. I was going like, boy, this is very impressive. You guys have really, really prepared your teams well. And you have to remember, these kids have, you know, gone back to football starting in August for them, right? The heat and you know, the summer when all their buddies are playing video games and hanging out at the mall or doing whatever they do. And you know, these boys were sweating it out at football practice, and again, looking forward to fine careers with both of these football programs. Great football programs, lots of tradition, of course, from both these football programs. These kids are going to have great futures in the game of football.
They didn't really get treated to much quote-unquote football weather, as it were, as summer turned to autumn either. It was a scorcher of a fall. And on fourth down, the Panthers going deep to Jaden Lord. Pass incomplete. A turnover on downs. We'll see the Fighting Irish now take possession at their own 28-yard line. Yeah, as Lord Tweedsmuir has come so close to scoring so many times and yet remains scoreless.
Absolutely. You're exactly right, Justin. Boy, they're going to, you know, come out of this game and say, boy, we had so many chances. But you know what? The game's not over, and let's see if they can create another turnover as they did in the last series for Vancouver College. But Vancouver College now look for, again, a steady dose of Mr. Bromley straight up the middle here.
It's pretty well the first play of the last drive. Well, technically the Fighting Irish did have one play that was walked back by a penalty flag, but then on the repeat of first down, you are right, the Panthers able to come up with that strip. This time there's a penalty flag on first down. Yet again, it's going to go against the defense. False start.
Yeah, T.J. Hutton just getting a little bit anxious here. But, boy, again, I want to commend the coaches and the players, of course, because, you know what, so I'm really impressed by the caliber of play here. I've watched a lot of football, a lot of grade 8 football this year, and, boy, both of these teams, all the grade 8 football teams, a very, very impressive talent level.
One of the things I feel like we talk about every year with the Grade 8 game as well, Jay, is just some early tentativeness, a lot of nerves when you get into a situation like this. Obviously, the kids playing on the same turf in the same stadium that the BC Lions play in. It's a big moment for them, and it can feel enormous. I feel like, though, as you said, it speaks well to the coaching staff of both of these teams. We didn't really see the kind of early game jitters that we typically associate with the Grade 8 championship game. Both teams very ready to play this one.
Absolutely.
Second down now here for the Fighting Irish, who need 2.5 yards to a fresh set. They're going to run the ball up the middle and get about 5. That'll move the chains for sure, as that running game has been very strong for Vancouver College. This time, ball in the hands of number 20, Alejandro Lando.
And again, boy, what a luxury Vancouver College has to have, you know, players. Now, this is their third tailback in, and Alejandro Lando is one of their most outstanding players and just did a great job of, you know, maintaining possession of that football. Notice that when he was getting tackled there, two hands on the ball. We always say two in trouble, two in traffic. Did a nice job of picking up a big first down with Rogan Bromley from the fullback position leading the way through that left-hand guard gap.
Bromley right now the lone man in the backfield. We do have a whistle being blown here. I believe there's a timeout being called by the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
Yeah, looking back at the seasons, you know, this is the third time that these two football teams have played each other. And Lord Tweedsmuir defeated Vancouver College way back on October 31st, 18-7. And they also defeated them in November. So, you know what? The Panthers, again, 2-0 against Vancouver College so far this year. On November 3rd, they also played, and the Panthers, in a kind of slugfest, defeated them 6-0. So, you know, always interesting to see when you play a team for the third time. It's certainly not easy to defeat them. But, again, kudos to both coaching staffs for doing a great job. And there's Coach Lando in there getting ready for getting the boys all prepared for, again, a big drive for Vancouver College. We can see in the end zones, there they are warming up. We have the first semifinal, the first AA semifinal in the Chaco Valley. All the way down from Vanderhoof. And we have the Vernon Panthers. Sean Smith and his football squad all the way here from Vernon. Great to see a true provincial final this year.
Absolutely. Still four more games coming up on semifinal Saturday after the Grade 8 championship game is done. And right now, there goes Rogan Bromley off to the races yet again. Finally brought down after contact with his ankles stopped him up, but he looks like he suffered an injury on the play, and that could be a costly one.
Yeah, very, very difficult to bring Mr. Bromley down with just a arm tackle, and Rumlin does a nice job of staying in bounds. He knows that the clock is a factor at this particular time, but we do have a penalty against Vancouver College. Look at holding. There's our head referee, Sarge Becker.
I believe that was the other number six, Ty Schofield, for the Panthers, who was the player finally able to wrap up the ankles of Rogan Bromley and put that rush to a halt. But penalty flag going to walk this one back in a big, big way. Wow.
And a couple of scores to announce from this week. Great job, JV football. Of course, the championship is going to be next week. Vernon Panthers over Robert Bateman, 52-12. Bolinas Whalers, 30-0 victory over Holy Cross in the AA Junior JV semifinals. They'll be playing against each other next week in the Dome.
Looking forward to that one. I believe I will be calling that game with you as well, Jay.
Absolutely, and in JV AAA football, Vancouver College defeats Mowat 29-28. Boy, that game, Mowat scored with 14 seconds left. Decided to go for two, Justin, and got stopped on the one-inch yard line. Oh, boy, I saw highlights from that game, and again, congratulations to Mowat JV's Elijah at quarterback. Boy, they have a very, very talented football team. And South Delta, Coach Martins, congratulations in the finals for the first time, 24-12 over Lord Tweedsmuir in the other AAA JV semifinal.
Right now, however, a long snap goes over the head of the quarterback, and the Fighting Irish have to scramble to jump on that one. Noah Gonzalez hopped on it like it was a live grenade. Third and long, to say the least. Vancouver College now all the way back on their own 26.
Yeah, just a little miscue there from the center. Just an inadvertent snap or a bad snap, but Noah Gonzalez does a nice job of getting on that football and making sure that the Panthers don't recover.
Third and 27 now for Vancouver College. Under 7 minutes to play, the Fighting Irish with a 14-0 lead here over the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers in the 2023 Grade 8 Championship game as they go right back to the run. Do the Fighting Irish. Good little pickup there for Mason Palmer, who looked like he'd been shot out of a cannon to begin this run.
Boy, did he ever. What great acceleration right up the middle, and nice pickup there on third down by Palmer. But, again, Vancouver College having a long way to go to get to the first down yardage and bring on the punt formation team for Vancouver College. Next week again, yeah, Justin, you mentioned that we've got the, of course, the AA championship. We've got the the AA JV championship, the AAA championship. Sorry, just watching this scene and making sure this young man is okay, the injured player there. The AAA JV championship. And then, of course, we have our All-Star game. I think we're in our fourth or fifth year now of the All-Star game. Coach Kremler is, again, the organizer. Excellent event, fine event. Of course, many of the university coaches come into town. It's their excuse to come to Vancouver for a visit. They start practice midweek, and they get all the All-Stars, all the people, all the players that are not playing in the championship game. And university coaches get out and get a chance to coach these fine young men, and we're going to be able to announce that game next week. And then, of course, we have the AA finals, and we have the AAA finals, of course, to end the evening next Saturday. So, again, folks, BC Place, if you can't get down here, of course, you're able to tune in on our webcast, and hopefully we can get you down to BC Place. Dress warmly. It is cold. Doesn't seem as cold today, Justin, but usually it is much colder than it is today.
I'm glad you brought your space heater with you, though, Jay.
Always prepared.
For sure. As the Fighting Irish will kick this one away on fourth down. Fourth and long, so no surprise there. Gathered in by the Panthers at their own 30. And they're going to chew up some big yards on this kick return that keeps going and could go all the way. Indeed, it does. Jaden Lord finally finds the house. And the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers are on the board with a touchdown just under 6 minutes to go in this one. Don't go anywhere, folks. This game is far from over.
Wow, 71 yards. The outstanding player, the outstanding receiver, two-way player from the Panthers. Jaden Lord all the way down the left-hand sideline again. 71 yards. Boy, I tell you, that is a huge play for the Panthers here. They're still in this football game, Justin.
Jaden Lord, have mercy. My goodness, what a run that was.
Panthers look like they're going for a two-point convert here. So, again, big play here. They've got lots of time left in this football game here, just under 6 minutes left. Let's see if the Panthers can punch in their two-point convert here.
And how huge does that negated touchdown scored by Ethan Gray loom right now in this game? Had it counted, we would potentially be looking at a tie game right now. Instead, Lord Tweedsmuir denied on the two-point convert attempt. Devlin Hudum with the carry. He's a little bit shaken up after being taken down. But it is an eight-point game with less than 6 minutes left to play. 5:47 on the clock. The Fighting Irish up 14-6 over the Panthers.
Boy, we're just waiting for something to happen for the Panthers, and that's exactly what happened. Well, again, the outstanding player for the Panthers, number 19, Jaden Lord, taking the ball 71 yards on a punt return all the way down the left-hand sideline, just outracing all of the Vancouver College defenders and scoring a big, big touchdown for the Panthers. Now it's up to their defense to stop. And also, big decision here for the Panthers as they are going to kick the ball off to Vancouver College. Are they going to try a short kick here, Justin? Are they going to kick it deep and rely on their defense to come up with a big stop?
I think you kind of have to at least give yourself a chance with the onside kick. We'll see what they elect to do, however. Javier Madar will kick this one away. Bit of a short one that is gathered in by the Fighting Irish at their own 43, where they will begin this drive first and 10. And it was Rogan Bromley, who else, who was able to jump on that ball.
Yeah, Vancouver College looked like they put their hands team out there, certainly put some of their players out there with reliable hands, and that's exactly what they did. And Rogan does a nice job of just securing that ball, catching it, going down, and allowing the Vancouver College to start this drive on the 42-yard line. So, again, 5 minutes and 45 seconds left in this Grade 8 championship game. Let's see if the Panthers can come up with a big stop on defense.
See if they can come up with another turnover. They've done it early in drives before, forced a strip or a fumble. Can they do it again? As it's a huge test of the Lord Tweedsmuir defense to try and climb back into this game. Right now they do make the stop on first down. Rogan Bromley trying to rumble up the middle, but halted after a gain of two.
Yeah, nice job. I'm really impressed with number six, Ty Schofield. He's got his technique down. He knows how to tackle the big man. He just goes down to his feet and does a nice job of making the tackle along with number 55, Mr. Singh there, the defensive tackle from the Panthers.
Second and eight now. Ball at the 45 as the drive continues for the Fighting Irish. Noah Gonzalez takes the short snap. We'll hand that ball off instantly right back to Rogan Bromley, who again will pick up a short gain of maybe 2 yards on the carry. And once again, we have an injured player shaken up on the tackle from Lord Tweedsmuir.
Yeah, it looks like, unfortunately, Ty Schofield is a little bit shaken up there. A couple of big tackles for him, and boy, he looks like he's just a little shaken up, but I can tell you right now that Ty Schofield does not want to come out of this football game, and hopefully we can see him back in this game. And, you know, brings up a point, Justin. I know that, with football, I tell you, it's the techniques, the coaching has improved so much in the last 10 years. As I said, I've been to so many football games this year. I've been to so many practices, and I just really commend the executive for making sure that, you know, coaches are trained. I commend all of the coaches for, you know, getting certified, making sure they understand how to coach tackling, how to coach blocking, how to coach the fundamentals of football. So, again, excellent job by the BC High School football coaches to, you know what, do a really fine job of coaching safe football. And, you know, it certainly shows, and I know there's a lot of parents out there questioning, you know, should my kid play football? But boy, I tell you, the way that high school football has gone and community football, coaches have done a great job of preparing the kids properly.
As Ty Schofield gets a nice little ovation from this crowd as he makes his way over to the sidelines. And the drive continues for the Fighting Irish. They go right back to the run game, this time back into the hands of Alejandro Lando. And he will move the sticks. That's the first down for Vancouver College.
Yeah, just back to their I formation with Rogan Bromley playing fullback. He's the lead blocker for Alejandro Lando. And just, again, trying to get the ball into the playmaker's hands to try to secure this drive. Huge drive for Vancouver College. And, again, first down on the Panther 42-yard line. Let's see if the Panthers continue to blitz, put some pressure on this run game.
And I'm sure the Fighting Irish would love to score another touchdown, stretch their lead even further, but it feels to me, Jay, that this drive is really about running down the clock, making sure that you're putting the ball in the hands of a runner. Try and pick up whatever yards that you can, but the main thing is let's keep this clock running and try and give the Panthers pretty well no time to do anything if they do get the ball back.
Yeah, exactly. And they're watching the clock right now, and they are certainly going to maintain, you know, their strong running game. But, again, very impressed. Panthers, nice job of tackling. Number 80, Max Howell, comes up with a big tackle from his linebacker position to just limit that gain by Bromley to only 3 yards. Nice tackle there by Max Howell, number 80 of the Panthers.
And I have to think that the Fighting Irish will go right back to the running game once more. Indeed they do. Ball in the hands of Alejandro Lando this time. Another short pickup for him of maybe 2 or 3 yards. But again, the clock continues to run, and time is the enemy of the Panthers at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. And boy, these guys are tired out there. You can tell this has been a very, very physical football game. And you know what? It's been a long season for these guys. We mentioned that earlier, practicing hard since August. And boy, I tell you, they have come in here tonight, Justin, and really, really given everything they have.
Timeout call. I believe it's Lord Tweedsmuir taking the opportunity to refocus and catch their breath here at a pivotal time. Less than 3 minutes remaining in regulation. And the Panthers trail by eight. Mentioned, of course, our ball sponsor, Bodden. Want to give them another shout out here. Bodden's goal is to give our customers an authentic experience, whether they are using one of our products in play or interacting with one of our team members. Bodden's mission statement is to create products that athletes love. It represents what Bodden stands for and what is central to everything that they do. Bodden Canada is proud to be the longstanding official sponsor for BC school sports, volleyball, and football. As it is a Bodden ball down on the field right now, at the Lord Tweedsmuir 40-yard line. His teams line up yet again following that Panthers timeout.
Hand off to Bromley up the middle.
As they go right back to Rogan Bromley, and he does what he has done throughout this game, and that has come up with some big yards. Move the chains, give the Fighting Irish a fresh set of downs.
Yeah, boy, it looks like Rogan Bromley is not feeling the effects of being, you know, playing a long football season and being into the fourth quarter. He hit that hole with tremendous power and tremendous speed. And, boy, Justin, I don't know about you, but I would not want to be tackling Rogan Bromley in this football game.
No, he looks like... You know, never mind the end of a long season, Jay. He looks like his day's just begun. He could play in one of the junior varsity games coming up later, perhaps.
Absolutely. And, yeah, we've got some big games, of course, coming up next week. The JV final, we talked about that. The Vernon Panthers are going to be playing against the Bolinas Whalers in the JV AA championship. Vancouver College, AAA JV. Coach Taggart, Coach Kazakowski, congratulations to you guys for their big win over the Mowat Hawks on Thursday. And South Delta, how about those South Delta Sun Devils? Coach Martins, good job coming up with a big victory over the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers. So Vancouver College and South Delta in the AAA JV final next Saturday, BC Place.
And I was kidding, of course, but it wouldn't surprise me necessarily if Rogan Bromley was on the sideline watching along for that one. It's Vancouver College back at it again 1 week from today in the junior varsity ranks. And Rogan Bromley once again throwing his weight around as the lead blocker for Alejandro Lando as the running game continues to generate yardage for the Fighting Irish, this time 6 yards on the carry to bring up second and four.
Yeah, I just want to mention number two, Rashawn Power, has made two great tackles for the Panthers in this quarter. And, again, just giving it his all from that cornerback position, doing a nice job of coming up and securing the tackles on the outstanding running backs from Vancouver College.
Time winding down in this one. We are inside the final 2 minutes of quarter number four. Fighting Irish up 14-6, and they have possession of the ball at the moment as well, though we do have a flag on the field here before this play gets started.
Yeah. Looks like possibly the center just kind of moved the ball before the snap of the ball or before the quarterback was able to call the cadence. So good job by these referees. Again, we've got some experienced referees throughout the day doing a nice job of picking up that call.
Walks back the Alejandro Lando pickup. But another big carry here from who else? Rogan Bromley. As I'm sure we'll take another look at it. His form is fascinating to me. The way he prepares himself for contact, just stiff-arming everybody. He's like shoveling his way downfield, essentially.
Yeah, really, he just has outstanding feet and is a great athlete for a big man, that's for sure. And they like to run over the left tackle, number 77, Carlos Declan is doing a good job. I hope I pronounced that name correctly there, folks. But, again, number 77, Carlos, you're doing a great job of opening up some big holes for your running backs today from that left tackle spot from with the Vancouver College Fighting Irish.
And 101 seconds remaining in this game. Logan Bromley going right back to work, rushing that ball up the middle, brought down after a gain of about six. But he continues to eat up yardage and perhaps more importantly, eat seconds off the clock.
Yeah, and I'd like to mention the left guard as well there and the center, number 52 and number 60, doing a great job of opening up the hole. Zach Langley, the left guard, is really doing an outstanding job from his left guard position. And the center, Rainey, you're doing a nice job there today of opening up some big holes, driving your feet. Excellent technique from that offensive line of Vancouver College against a very, very talented defensive line of the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
You're right. They are running it up the middle a fair amount, the Fighting Irish, and that does speak to the strength of the linemen doing the yeoman's work to make that possible, of course, as Noah Gonzalez takes a knee.
Yeah, good sportsmanship here shown by Vancouver College. They know that that Lord Tweedsmuir cannot stop the clock any longer. They're just going to down the ball. They've told the Panthers defensive line, hey, guys, we're just going to take a step back and down the ball here and, again, let that clock run out. Of course, in American football, that clock will just run out as Vancouver College quarterback Noah Gonzalez just taking a knee. And, boy, what an entertaining game, Justin Moore said.
It was. It really, really was. And you can see the heartache right now in the body language and demeanor of the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers players. We just saw one player collapse to the turf, and that's TJ Hutton, who really played his heart out, as did really the entire roster for Lord Tweedsmuir. But it is the Vancouver College Fighting Irish who are victorious in the Grade 8 Championship game, a day to remember for those young men as they swarm the field in celebration. And it's a tough finish for the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers, but these are kids who, I assure you, it might not be tomorrow, it might not be next week, it might not be next month, Jay, it might not even be next year. But at some point, these kids will look back on today as a positive memory and the work that they put in to get here, even if it didn't end the way they wanted it to.
Absolutely. What a fantastic season. Again, all Grade 8 football teams should be commended. And you know what? Just the Panthers fighting all the way to the end. And there's the boys shaking hands. A lot of these guys have gone to camps together. A lot of these guys have played 7-on-7 leagues together. And, you know, they know and they respect. That's such a great thing about football, of course, is that you battle hard on the field, but at the end of the day, you know, you're all football players and you know, you're all football brothers out there, and it's just great to see. And as you said, Justin, you got guys like Jordan Thiessen, and you've got, you know, the players that are going to just be outstanding players throughout their careers. They've got outstanding football players and or outstanding football programs, and boy, it's just going to be fun to watch these young men progress through their football careers. Keep your heads up, Panthers. Keep your heads up, guys.
And you love to see the respect, as you mentioned, between these teams on a day like this. Rogan Bromley led the handshake line for Vancouver College, and it wasn't much of a handshake line for him. It was more of a hug line, because he hugged pretty well every single guy on the other team, including the opposition coaches. So that speaks to the respect between these teams, between these coaching staffs as well. And ultimately, you love to see it. It's what the game is all about.
Oh, absolutely. I've had a chance to coach Rogan Bromley in many of my camps. He's actually a pretty good quarterback himself. And, boy, he's just the nicest kid out there, very humble. You know, just knows that he knows he's a good player, but it's just a humble young man that is a great sport and very caring, giving young man that, you know, you could see again by that handshake that he just, you know, really respects the game of football and respects his teammates and respects his coaches and, of course, respects his opponents, the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers, today in this situation.
And he was hardly the only one handing out hugs in that handshake line either. He just happened to be leading the lineup, so I put an extra focus on him. But there was a lot of hugs, a lot of respect between really the entirety of the staffs, both the roster and coaches between both of these teams, as both Lord Tweedsmuir and Vancouver College take a knee down along the sidelines here where the trophies are about to be handed out.
Yeah, we've got the MVP, we've got outstanding lineman, we've got outstanding back, and boy, I wouldn't want to be the one that made the decisions on these particular awards. Well, there's our left tackle that we mentioned earlier. Carlos, congratulations on winning the Outstanding Lineman Award.
Number 77, Carlos Dacklin.
Yeah, George Oswald, longtime football guru here from British Columbia, of course, with the Notre Dame Jugglers. Has the pleasure of being able to hand out a trophy to a Vancouver College player.
Outstanding lineman in the Grade 8 championship game. He's got a big smile on
his
face.
Big smiles, yeah, isn't that great? Back.
Jaden Lord winning the outstanding back in this game. And a well-deserved honor from a guy who was probably the best player on the field for the Panthers in this game. Came up with some big, big plays.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, there's a big smile from Jaden. I've seen that smile before. Boy, again, great great kid. And, you know, one thing that's interesting, too, I know a lot of these parents of these kids, and boy, the parent support is something that is just so vital in the development of these players. And you know, so many of these parents, again, have just been outstanding supporters of their sons and of their children.
That's Rogan Bromley. The most outstanding player of this game, and it's hard to argue that selection. He had both of the touchdowns for Vancouver College here today, and probably could have added another in the final minute had the Fighting Irish really pressed for the end zone. They did not. They really just wanted to get that game over with, but he was just outstanding all day long. And now the championship plaque being presented to the Vancouver College Fighting Irish.
Let's go, captains. Get up there. Yeah, boy, there's a dejected group, hey? Those kids, again, have played.
I've been there.
Yeah.
I have played in this Grade 8 championship game. I have lost it. With the Handsworth Royals back in 2000, some 23 years ago.
Boy, you remember that, eh, Justin?
I do. It's a hard pill to swallow in the moment, but I do look back on that day and the whole experience of getting to play in this building, getting to hear my name called by the PA announcer every time I made a play. It is a great memory to look back on now, even if it really stung at the time.
Yeah, great job again. There's your captain, Sadu, Thiessen, Lord. And Hutton, again, guys that have played together, Cloverdale, minor football, all those years together. And, boy, it sure showed that, you know, kudos to the Cloverdale minor guys for, you know, really developing outstanding football players. And Vancouver College, you know, a lot of players that played for the Westside Warriors. So, again, kudos to the Westside Warriors as well for developing so many fine football players that have gone on to play and excel at the high school level. There you go. There's a big smile from your captain and quarterback, Noah Gonzalez. There you go, Mason Palmer. Rogan Bromley. Congratulations, guys. Boy, that's a lot of medals to have for those Vancouver College guys. Look at those smiles. Beautiful. Congratulations, guys.
And, folks, as we have mentioned many times already, that will do it for the Grade 8 championship game, but that is just the starter course on a day full of football here. The first of five straight games under the dome on semifinal Saturday here at BC Place Stadium. It is the BC School Sports High School Football Championships. And we got lots of great action still coming your way. Up next, it's Nechako Valley versus Vernon. As you said, Jay, really the provincial championships having a provincial flavor to them. And that is exemplified best by the contest we have coming up next. So don't go anywhere. Kickoff between Nechako Valley and Vernon a little over 7 minutes away, as we will continue to bring you the action all day long here from BC Place Stadium. My name is Justin Morissette. He is Jay Prepchuk. It is the Vancouver College Fighting Irish who emerged victorious over the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers in the Grade 8 championship game, but we got lots of football action still ahead.
Uber account for your teen with trackable trips and highly rated drivers. Receive 60% off your next three rides and Uber teen accounts when using the promo code BCTeenFall23. Hey fans, Uber is running a special promotion just for BCS athletes on their